First, we'll start with three pictures that are 1760 by 2640. In the It's Litho website, we can upload the photos one at a time and create the lithophanes. I'll include a link to the website in the description below. So you can see here all the settings that I used that will fit the frame. When you're finished setting all the parameters for the lithophane, you need to download the STL file and also the color lithophane that will get printed, as you can see here, and put on the back of the lithophane, which will give it color. Then I can cut it to size. Next, I can print the lithophane. There's a link in the description below for the material that I used. Next, I need to attach the color prints to the back of the lithophanes. So to do that, I'm going to use some spray adhesive, but I need to mask it off so that it doesn't get spray adhesive on the edges. Then I can spray them. And stick them down. And there's what they look like. Next, I need to get some accurate measurements off the lithophanes so that I can draw the plans for the frame. So here I've started a drawing in Fusion 360 that has the basic curve of the lithophane that'll be used to create slots for it to fit into. Then I'll measure the power cord and create a hole in the middle that it can fit into, and the switch and an opening for it. Then I'll measure the cord itself and create some little nubs that stick up that I can wind the cord around for strain relief. Next, I'll measure the power cord connector and create a mount for the connector to be attached to. Next, I need to create a way to attach the lighting fixture to the base. And that part is done. Next, I can design the rails that hold the sides of the lithophane and create a way for them to attach to the base and the top. Next, I'll create an opening in the edges of the rail to put a little lens into so that the light will come through. Then I can create a little foot that snaps on the bottom, kind of holds the whole thing together. So for the top, I started by just copying the basic shape of the base so that it would match, and then created a slope and put the horses' names into the sides, right where they line up with the lithophane that's going to be right below. Now we need to make a dome lithophane that'll fit into that top opening. First, I'll start with a little photo, 251 by 251 pixels. Here's the image settings, in case you want to like create your own, and also the model settings. And then just go back and hit refresh. And download it, and it's ready to go. Here I'm designing the light socket mounts, threads to hold the socket in place, little notches for the wires to come out, a little well that'll fit into, and a little locking mechanism to hold the two halves together. Here's the other half. And that's how they look. And then a little dovetail that'll hold the arm in place, and it kind of locks the whole thing together too. These are notches for the wiring to come down. And here's what all the parts look like when it's put together. Here's a more detailed view of how all the parts go together. Now it's time to get this thing built. So I'll start by printing the base. Then the rails. and the rail lens. Then I'll print the feet. And the top. Next, I'll print the lettering for each of the three horses. Next, I'll print the umbrella that fits on the top and holds the dome. And the dome. Then I can print the light tower sockets and the light tower arms. Time for some assembly. I'll get some heat shrink tubing ready. And get the power connector. Tin the end of the wires and the posts. And solder them on. And then put the heat shrink tubing up and heat it up. Then I can install the power connector onto the base. Next, I'll install the switch. I'll cut the cable to length, strip the ends, and tin the wires. Next, I'll solder the power line onto the switch. And apply the heat shrink. Next, I can put the light fixture into the socket mount and anchor it with two screws. It should clip together here and then twist to lock it. And the dovetail joint on the arm, once you slide it up in there, will keep it from coming apart. Now I need to thread the wires down through that hole and down the inside of the arm and through that little keeper at the bottom. Then I'll do the other one. And install the lamp holder onto the base. Now I can connect all the wiring. Here's the specs on the power supply I used. And then I'll use some hot glue to attach the wire connectors. And a little bit to hold the wires. Get that other bulb in there. And a little bit more glue to make sure that switch stays in place. Whoa, that's bright. Okay, time for final assembly. Whoops, wrong way around. This was a fun project, and I learned a lot. Thanks for watching!